This example says, in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the current flowing through the battery. We need to assume the diodes are ideal. There are two situations given to us. Let's discuss both of these one by one. In the situation shown in figure, we can see that the battery will supply the current in this direction. And when current is flowing from right to left, in this situation we can see that the diode D1 will be reversed bias because current will not be allowed to pass from N side to the P side of this diode. So this will be reversed bias and it will behave like an open circuit, as we need to treat diodes are ideal. And this current will pass through D2 and the whole current in turn will pass through the 4 ohm resistance. So for this situation A, if we draw the equivalent circuit diagram, it will look like this situation. Here we can see that this diode D1 is reverse bias and D2 is forward bias, so current will pass through it, or it will act like a straight wire. And there is a battery of 30 ohm resistance connected across it. These resistances of 6 ohm, 3 ohm and 4 ohm respectively. Now if the current is passing through it, these two resistances will behave in parallel. And 4 ohm will act as it is connected in series with these two in parallel. So here we can write the equivalent resistance of the circuit will be 6 and 3 in parallel will be given as 6 multiplied by 3 by 6 plus 3. And as 4 is in series, it will be plus 4. So this can be written as 18 by 9. It is 2 plus 4 in all. The equivalent resistance across the battery will be 6 ohm. And the current through the battery can be directly given as 30 by 6. This is a 30 volt battery. So it is 30 by 6. That will be 5 ampere current which will pass through it. That will be the answer to this problem. And be careful, here we have analyzed that diode D2 is forward bias, because in this case current will flow from P side to N side. Because the current cannot flow from N side to P side of the diode D1. Similarly, if we analyze the situation in figure B, the battery is reversed. You can see the positive side of battery is connected to the left side of the circuit. So when current will pass through it, you can see the current will be going from left to right side. So here you can see that diode D1 will act as a forward bias, and when current will approach here, in this situation you can see that D2 will also act as a forward bias diode because the current has to flow. Here when current will approach from D1, it has two paths to flow. One is from 3 ohm, other is from D2. Then obviously we can see the potential of this side, which will become 30 volt and this will be less. So D2 will be forward bias and current will flow through both of these directions. So the equivalent circuit here we can draw as this will be the 4 ohm resistance, and here 6 ohm resistance and 3 ohm resistances are there. And this D1 will act as a straight wire because it is forward bias and the battery of 30 volt is connected across the circuit. And in this situation you can see that due to forward biasing of diode D1, this 4 ohm is short circuited. So whole of the current will pass through D1 and the current through 4 ohm will be negligible, or we can treat it to approximately be equal to 0. So here the total resistance across the battery can be written as only 6 and 3 ohm in parallel, because the current would always be flowing through the low resistance path in the beginning and then it will be distributed between 6 ohm and 3 ohm resistance. So your equivalent resistance will be 6 into 3 by 6 plus 3. That will be 2 ohms only. And the current through battery now can be given as 30 by 2. This will be 15 ampere. That will be the answer to the part B of this problem.